Hello everybody, myself is Surjit Akhre. I am the first Indian artist who has achieved a postgraduate degree in easel painting from the Academy of Fine Arts, Repin Institute of Painting, Sculpture and Architecture in St. Petersburg, Russia. I am also the founder president of Rariks Art Club, affiliated to Russian Center of Science and Culture, New Delhi. I have an experience of 40 years as a professional artist. Let us start our own painting. Before you get started, decide what you are trying to represent in your painting and plan the composition of your painting around it. It is some kind of mental map or composition before you begin to paint. Firstly, you have to draw the forms. For this, first you can use pencil or small flat brush and do rough sketch of the composition. In art, the element of space include positive and negative space as well as two-dimensional and three-dimensional space. Effective use of illusion gives two-dimensional work a three-dimensional appearance. Sometimes these illusions work so well that confuse our perceptions. Then you draw the contour. When you compose, you have to keep in mind the negative space. Negative space isn't the place your mind repeats to when a painting isn't going well. Negative space is the space between objects or part of an object or around it. Studying this can have a surprisingly positive effect on a painting. Too often, when we paint something, we stop observing and start painting from memory instead of painting what is in front of us. We paint what we know and remember about the subject. Often by working from the negative spaces rather than focusing on the subject, you end up with a much more accurate painting. The identification of negative spaces will allow you to identify which edges of the object need to be hard edges and which could be soft edges. You are identifying those which give you the essence of the image. Focusing on negative space rather than the actual object or subject of a painting takes practice. You have got to train yourself to see around this object. After completing your drawing, it is time to think your palette. Now you can pick any ground color that complements your composition. Here first I apply gray color all over the forms. Apply the colors with bold strokes. When you make the contours, you keep in mind about the negative space, what shape you are giving for the negative space. You can see here the shapes of negative space. Form and shapes are areas or masses which define objects in space. Form and shape imply space. Indeed, they cannot exist without space. There are various ways to categorize form and shape. Form and shape can be thought of as either two-dimensional or three-dimensional. Two-dimensional form has width and height. It can also create the illusion of three-dimensional objects. Three-dimensional shape has depth as well as width and height. The positive space is easiest to understand. Generally, it is the space occupied by your subject. Conversely, negative space is the space that is not your subject. Here I have filled the positive space with gray color. Now draw the details of the face. Then I mix black and blue thinned with water and apply in the forms where I need dark color. Then I mix another dark brown tone and to apply in the bottom of the forms. Shapes and forms are perceivable by the human eye because of value, color and chroma, intensity, contrast. The interaction between shapes and forms that unite to define space is one of the most important. Visual spaces are divided into two categories. Positive space, where shape and form exist to create the impression of things, and negative space that indicate the empty space between. A successful composition relies on a balance of both. In negative space, drawing instead of observing the positive shape of an object. you draw the shape of the space around this object. This may include any background detail or pattern, or it may be drawn as a simple silhouette. In many drawing books, you will find an example which begins with drawing an outline of the object and shading all around it. Although it is a silhouette, this is not correct. Negative space drawing. As you draw the outline, you are doing a positive drawing, focusing on the positive spaces, the solid shapes of the object. The correct approach to negative space drawing involves observing the shapes formed between different parts of the object or between one edge of the object and a boundary. By drawing the background spaces or shapes between the edges of the object and the opposing edge or boundary, the positive form of the object is left undrawn, resulting in a correct negative space drawing. This is the reverse of normal positive space drawing, where you would be looking at the form and drawing its edges. Seeing negative spaces correctly is a skill worth developing. Negative spaces use a great deal when you want to avoid outlining and create true value drawing. Thank you. It is needed when you have a texture like light colored hair or grass. When you need to focus on the dark shadows behind underneath the strands. The foreground, the positive shapes of light, hair or grass are left behind as white paper, while the shadows and dark are drawn with dark charcoal or pencil. Now I mix the other tone to fill in the figure. I mix Indian red and the black, apply in the left side of the figure. Now I cover the whole area of positive space with dark brown. To give the light shade on the forehead, nose and jaw, I leave the gray of the background. A sound understanding of negative space drawing is critical for watercolor painting, as a watercolor is built through a progressive overlying of negative space areas, working from light to dark. Every positive shape is surrounded by negative space. It is important when composing your drawing or painting to look at both the positive and negative shapes, and then to look back and forth between them to accurately assess proportions and relationships. Learning to draw negative shapes demands a whole new way of seeing. Regardless of what you are drawing or painting, the positive and negative shapes within the composition can be regarded as abstract shapes. You need to forget the name of objects and what you think you know about them and simply see them as shapes among a group of interlocking abstract shapes, like a jigsaw puzzle. Some of those shapes are defined by the edge of the paper of canvas. I use orange both sides, which will give contrast and will give some optical illusion. Why negative space is important? Learning to see negative spaces is very important for drawing proportions and relationship accurately. Negative spaces are very important for creating compositions that are balanced and unified. Negative space in a composition can help identify the focal point. Negative space is most often neutral or contrasting. Focusing our attention on the main subject, the positive shape, and providing a place for the viewer's eye to rest. Without enough negative space, a composition can look busy with too many distracting elements. Positive and negative space together create a figure, ground relationship, one of the six principles of Gestalt theory in design, in which the positive shape is the figure and the negative shape is the ground. This is how we perceive an object as distinct from its background. However, that is not always the case. Sometimes the positive and negative shapes can switch roles. When this is done deliberately so that a shape could be seen as either figure or ground, it is called a figure. ground reversal. Other Gestalt principles are good continuation and closure, suggesting that our eyes like to close shapes. These perceptual principles are often used intentionally in logo design, embedding a meaningful part of the logo without the negative space of the design, which our eyes make sense of by reading the negative space as a closed shape. The visual balance of positive and negative space is considered an element of good design. Similar to the Japanese concept of Noten, the balance of light and dark. In both concepts, one element of the duality cannot exist without the other, and both are necessary. Seeing negative space involves learning to see in a new abstract way and can help you create a more abstract composition. Take a pure white and make the sharp edges. To give the contrast in the middle, I am using lemon yellow, which is complementary color of the dark brown. To make the figure come out, you can use contrast also. After filling all the canvas, let us see from the distance. Now you will realize the negative space gives optical illusion. can confuse sometimes where to more focus. This time we will be look at what is not there, the negative space. The rule of space applies to artwork, photography, advertising, illustration, picturing objects to which the artist wants to apply the illusion of movement, or which is supposed to create a contextual bubble in the viewer's mind. This can be achieved, for instance, by leaving white space in the direction the eye of a portrait person are looking, or when picturing a runner, adding white space in front of him rather than behind him to indicate movement. Then I do dark shade in the forms to give the depth. To give the depth in the form, now I apply dark shade in the contour and give highlights to another side to give the 3D effect of the foam. We have to give the effect of reflection, which is dimmed and highlighted. Negative space is employed as a brain fooling method of seeing shapes with clarity. Negative drawing is a conscious method of working that isolates and protects area of your paper.